have a look on different, here size I have taken as the total assets. So in event year, the Crompton Greaves size is always higher compared to the target companies. So since it has acquired smaller target size companies, it has helped for more and more successful mergers and acquisitions. For findings, what we can say, the liquidity aspect, like in terms of the current ratio, quick ratio and the net working capital ratio, has been lower for the Crompton Greaves compared to the control firms. But in terms of profitability, say for example, the return on capital employed and return on net worth, it has improved after the company have gone for more and more mergers and acquisition from 2001 and has generated higher returns compared to the control firms, that is those firms who have not gone for any mergers and acquisitions. Similarly, if you take into consideration the solvency aspect, the total debt ratio has been higher for the control firms, but the Crompton Greaves have higher earning capacity to pay off the debts. If you talk about the asset turnover ratio, it has improvement in the operating cash flows from the asset productivity after it has gone for mergers and acquisitions. If you look into aspect the EVA and the rate of EVA, it is far higher compared to the control firms. They are showing that the shareholders' value has been added. This is the overall picture of the results. Liquidity does not improve, but solvency, profitability, efficiency and EVA improves. Although solvency improves after certain period of post-M&A period. So these are the different ratios. In the conclusion, I would say, like to say that mergers and acquisitions have improved the profitability of the company, which explains the general hypothesis that profitability improves after mergers and acquisitions because of cost reduction or because of an increase in the market power or because of different operational synergies. The liquidity position of the Crompton Greaves have decreased because the company who have adopted the organic strategy or those who have not gone for mergers and acquisitions have improved well compared to the Crompton Greaves. The solvency position have improved. Overall, the financial performance have improved except liquidity, as well as the non-performance financial performance of the company have improved, like increasing the brand value, improving the core competence and other factors that I have discussed. So M&A done by the Crompton Greaves were done taking into consideration the related deals, acquiring targets that are relatively smaller, gain market, gain M&A knowledge through acquisition experience, and independent board, is family owned and a group business, and have good quality of managers. And these might be the factors that have helped in the post M&A performance of the company. These are the list of references that we have cited. These are the author details. Thank you.
I have a question.